Hello, every pony out to Lisiana here. Link to my Divinian art in the description below and also for my Patreon if you like to do that. Warning, this video will contain pictures from Google that is not mine, so please give respect to the owners of these pictures and copyrights. It's also going to contain a wild theory about Starlight Glimmer still being evil or plotting something to, you know, overtake Equestria. So if you don't like to hear about this, click away or else stay. Yeah, here we go. 3, 2, 1. I know the first question you will ask me is how I could come up with this theory when we have seen that Starlight is, you know, trying to reform herself after she have seen the world being completely destroyed and stuff like that. But here I'm going to answer. She definitely cares about the world being destroyed and there not being any ponies left and not being any life left. I do believe in that, but I also believe that she is manipulating Twilight to think that she cares because she is a good manipulator, as we have seen with the, you know, the town where everybody was equal and stuff like that. And she also have wants to be, you know, the one, the leader, the one that makes the decisions. She actually wants to be in Twilight's shoes, or how to say that. And how is the best way to, you know, get close to your enemy? It's like, keep your friends close, but your enemies closer. And I actually feel like Starlight is doing that right now. I definitely feel like she knows what she was doing when she cast the spell on the main six. Maybe she wasn't completely sure about how it would work, but I'm also sure that it was some kind of mind spell, because she says later on that maybe if I mixed this spell with another spell, the outcome would have been different. And yeah, I don't like the sound of that. Let's just keep it to that. And we also see that she don't have a problem giving the main six orders, even though that they're under the spell. Maybe she didn't think it was that serious. But in later episodes, she have actually learned that it's not a good idea to put spells on her friends. So she should have been freaking out and trying to help them get out of the spell instead of, you know, using them as her own puppets to do whatever she liked. But when, you know, Twilight comes back and we see her being, you know, remorseful and trying to make up for her mistakes by apologizing and helping the other main six, I still feel there's some part of her that knew that she had to do this, or how to say that without sounding very conspicuous. Imagine she knows it's a bad thing to cast the spells on her friends, right? But she also knows what you're supposed to do to complete a friendship problem, or how to say that. And maybe this is the only way that she figured out that she could impress Twilight and make all of the friendship problems in a day, is to mess up, you know. I don't know how to say it. I'm not convinced that she did this without thinking it all the way through. And I was also thinking about the episode where she comes again and she have been spying on the main six, and she sees Twilight's lesson about, you know, how they became the main six with the Sonic Rainboom and how they got their cutie marks and stuff like that. And I was like, it's a good thing that she didn't have a presentation about the, you know, Tree of Harmony or the Elements of Harmony, because that could have been even more, you know, I don't know, devastating or how to say that. Imagine, you know, Starlight going back in time or forward in time or how it is, and destroying the Tree of Harmony, if that is even possible. I don't know, maybe it's not possible to destroy the Tree of Harmony. But then there would be no map, there will not be no Twilight's Castle, there would be no nothing, actually, as we see in the future again. But would it be enough for, you know, Starlight to stop what she was doing? Maybe it was too late if she have, you know, completely destroyed the Tree of Harmony. It had been there before, you know, Celestia and Luna and stuff like that. So, I don't know, maybe that would have been, you know, devastating. And Starswell, the bearded, had to come out from his time travel. I actually feel like he's trapped in time and space somewhere. And actually help to restore the Tree of Harmony or something like that. Actually, a great idea for episode I had was that, you know, Twilight becomes evil. For what reason, I don't know. But maybe she becomes, you know, infused with Sombra's magic by finding his horn. Or she becomes seduced by Queen Chrysalis. Or it's like I'm telling you that Starlight is trying to overtake her place and by accident casts this spell that makes Twilight more evil than she is, or something like that. I don't know how that sounds in your head, but I actually feel like that is pretty possible. Maybe she will cast a spell on the other, you know, princesses, Cadence and Celestia and Luna also. So it was those four against the other main six. And I would actually think that could actually redeem Starlight completely if she knew that the, you know, that there was a possibility of somebody, you know, overtaking her again. After the fact that she's trying to overtake everything, or how to say that, I really do feel like there's a possible way that she can redeem herself 100%, because I know that she has shown remorse in other episodes. There's, for example, the episode with the changeling, where we see that she's sad and understands, you know, where the changeling comes from and stuff like that. But who isn't to say it's all an act and she's trying to gain, you know, Twilight's trust. She's trying to gain the other main six's trust, and now she have that. So the only thing that she have to do for now is gain Discord's trust and, you know, the other princess's trust. So, well, I'm guessing that she has Cadence, so it's only Celestia and Luna that she's missing, and of course Discord. But I'm like, I don't feel like it's going to be that easy to gain Discord's trust now that she now that he has been burned by, you know, T-Rex. So I really do feel like maybe it could also be an episode where Discord actually saves the princesses from Starlight, and it could be a devastating episode by telling, you know, you shouldn't be trusting even somebody that you have learned to love or learned to be a good friend with. I know that it's a hard lesson, but I really do feel like the show actually needs this about right now. Because we have seen every other lesson in the book, but besides, you know, losing a good friend that you hold near and dear. Maybe it's Spike and Changeling, but I actually feel like it could be even more devastating if it was Twilight and, you know, Starlight. So yeah, that is actually all that I have to say. Sorry about the alarm going off, but I'm going to be picked up by my mom and dad. So I'll be off, you guys, but do remember that inspiration is right around the corner. Do remember to take care of yourself and loved ones, and do write in the comments if you feel like I'm way over my head with these inspirations for episodes. I would really like to see Stars World the Bearded in an episode, the background story for Celestia and Luna, all of it, and maybe some more information on Starlight, so we don't have to keep her in the dark. Because just see now, where is she? She just learned, you know, a lesson. But why isn't she in the, you know, further lessons, or how to say that? I'm still thinking that they're keeping her behind the lines, or how to say that, to take her forward when Queen Chrysalis is coming, or when, you know, Sombra is coming back, or whatever. I'm really going to say I believe it's going to be Chrysalis, but time will tell. Yeah, that's actually all. Okay, yeah, bye.